Hey, what's up? This is Jay Watts, but when I'm on my garage, they call me DJ, Dirty Jeff. I'm serious though. I want to show a video for people who are trying to do these at-home installations for transmissions. And I'm reading a lot of comments about people installing their transmission saying, I can't start the car. I installed the transmission and the car won't start. And they don't get a click, a tick, or nothing. Usually what happens is the torque converter that sits in here. Let me show you what a torque converter is. Whoops, look at that. Hold up for a second. Yeah, this big ass torque converter down here. Forget it, I'm not picking that shit up, it's too heavy. You know what a torque converter is because you took it out. Now, the torque converter, if you don't get it pushed all the way back on the splines to where it matches up to the pump, it's gonna leave about a quarter inch space. And with that little quarter inch gap, if you try to match this bell housing up to the back of the engine, you're gonna need bolts. And the bolts will try to, you will try to use bolts to pull it together. Don't do that. Because if you need bolts to match your transmission to the bell housing just to squeeze it together, that means your pump is not seated properly. And you're probably gonna crush the pump because the pump sits right back there. And if you crush that pump, the little bearings and everything inside of there, I mean, you just made it a much bigger problem than what you got. So if you try to start the car, the starter hits the flywheel won't spin. It's all locked up. And people be like, well, damn, man, my damn car won't. I keep seeing comments, man, my car won't start. I just finished installing the transmission. My car won't start. I'm like, well, are you getting a tick, a click? Is it? Well, it won't even turn over. I'm like, it's not even trying to start, not even turning over. I say, you know what the issue is? You didn't seat the torque converter all the way back there. You got to push that thing all the way back. You seat it all the way in there. You should be able to push that transmission bell housing all the way up to the engine. Clink. It'll hit like the little guides, the little metal guides, and it'll come together. Then you can get a screw, the bolts or whatever, the transmission bell housing bolts, and you can actually bolt them in by hand. You can screw them in and it's easy. All the way by hand, it'll be sitting flush with the engine. But if you try to match it and you can get your finger in there and you like, no matter what I do, the engine won't match with the bell housing. There's a gap in between it. But if I use the bolts, then I can make it pull together. Do not do that. I'm gonna show a quick little video on how you can tell if you've matched up your torque converter to your pump properly so you can slide it up to the flywheel real easy. Check out this video. Okay, the easiest way to tell if you got a transmission bolted in right, I got my two bottom bolts on each side. Transmission is lined up, pushed in. Torque converter is matched up to the flywheel. The bolts, I haven't put the bolts on, just the studs are sticking out. But if you see the studs sticking out, put your hand up through the bottom hole and rock the torque converter back and forth like this. What that is those are my bolts sticking through, hitting the sides of the holes where they're at. So that lets you know my torque converter is sitting on my pump correctly. If I couldn't turn this torque converter with my fingers like this, then that would mean my torque converter is not matched to my pump all the way. I don't have it pushed all the way back. So if you can't, with your hand, just freehand, move that. Your torque converter is not on the pump correctly. You gotta unmatch it and seat it back further on that transmission, then match it back up again. This should be spinning by hand freely. So you can see my bolt to my torque converter is coming through my flywheel and my finger is going through the bottom of the transmission and I could just move it like. That lets you know all my holes are through, I can't turn it any further, and the torque converter spins freely. If you can't move it with your finger freely, real easy, that means you don't have the torque converter sitting on the pump correctly. It's not pushed all the way back in, or you push it all the way back in on the wrong section, and you've locked it on there. You gotta get it back off and do it right.